everyone, welcome to SKM at Concept. So today we are going to discuss about a short review on progestin challenge test. So what is actually progestin challenge test? So this is a test which we use to determine the cause of amenorrhea. So amenorrhea basically means the lack of menstruation. So how do you think we can take this test for finding the cause of amenorrhea? Usually a progesterone or a progesterone like drug is given for 5 to 10 days. And after that, we are asking the patient and we are noticing whether any withdrawal bleeding is present or not. So if there is any withdrawal bleeding seen after this progesterone intake, then we can confirm the cause of amenorrhea as an ovulation. However, if withdrawal bleeding is absent, then we have to again test for the FSH levels in her body. So what we can understand by testing the FSH level? So obviously, if the FSH level is really high, then it means that she is having a hypergonadotrophic hypogonadism. So in this condition, the patient will present with an insufficient sex hormone production in gonads. So because of this reason, there will be increased GnRH in her body as well as increased LH and FSH hormones. However, if the FSH is really low in her body after the test, then again we have to go for a combined estrogen and progesterone challenge test. So if withdrawal bleeding is seen after this combined estrogen and progesterone therapy, then we can come to a conclusion that she is suffering from hypogonadotrophic hypogonadism, which means that there is an insufficient GnRH release from her pituitary axis. So again, definitely, as there is an insufficient GnRH release, this will lead to decreased GnRH and decreased LH and FSH. However, if the withdrawal bleeding is absent after this combined estrogen progesterone therapy, then we can conclude that amenorrhea is due to some endometrial or anatomical reasons. So this is all about the progesterone challenge test. That's it. Thank you.